Manchester United playing Spurs this weekend. We're only three games into the season, but technically this is a must win after the atrocities at Brighton last week. Spurs have won two on the bounce. They're looking good. But what team will Jose Mourinho start? Will he make changes from that 3-2 defeat against Brighton? I think he will. Now, before I get into this, please subscribe to United People's TV if you're new to the channel. Lots of United content going out. And let's be honest, right now is a time where lots of United fans have got a lot to say. But this Spurs game, Man United need to win it, don't you? Three games into a season, you rarely say this is a must-win game. But for the momentum with the club and everything that's gone on since the Brighton game, a lot of it not really to do with the on-the-pitch performance, Man United need to win this. And Spurs coming into the game in good form. Harry Kane has broken his August duck. Spurs didn't sign anybody under Pochettino. A little bit similar to Man United with the frustrations in the transfer market. But you've got two managers who have approached it to the media differently. Pochettino saying, look, I'm going to get the most out of the squad I've already got. And Spurs, still for me, have one of the best squads in the Premier League. But who will Jose Mourinho start for United against Spurs? This is a starting 11 that I've gone for. As you can see, different formation and a few changes as well. First change in defence. Go back to last year, Spurs away at Wembley. Probably the worst away game I've ever been to. One of the worst performances you'll ever see. United 1-0 down after 10 seconds and it was downhill from there. Really poor game. In that match, Jose Mourinho reverted to Smalling and Jones. FA Cup final at Wembley. Mourinho reverted to Smalling and Jones. Will he start Smalling and Jones in this game? I don't think he will. But I think he'll start Chris Smalling at the heart of defence with Lindelof and Bailly either side of him in a 5-3-2 formation. Because let's be honest, the defence against Brighton was woeful. Lindelof and Bailly both culpable for individual mistakes which cost us the game. And Mourinho is a man who makes changes. Made two at half-time against Brighton. I think he'll make changes in this game. And for me, maybe Smalling coming in and making that a back three might take a little bit of pressure off Lindelof and Bailly. I don't know. Let me know what you would think. Do we want to keep it in that same formation we've been using so far, 4-3-3? Or do you want to switch it to the 5-3-2, which looked better in pre-season? Certainly than the 4-3-3 does at the moment. Now my wing-backs, going for sure, I'm going to bring Valencia back into the team. I think he'll definitely start. We've missed having Valencia, I suppose, but we need the experience of him at right-back. We need him covering for when Bailly makes a mistake, because he will make a mistake. And I want to see Luke Shaw play as I think he can play as a wing-back. He's had a very good start to the Premier League season. And Shaw, as a wing-back, should be sensational because you've got three centre-backs, which means Shaw can concentrate on the overlapping runs because there'll be no width up front from the two strikers. The width will need to come from Shaw and Valencia, and I think Shaw can really provide that. Now in midfield, making a few changes here. No Andreas Pereira. You've got Fred there and you've got Matic back with Pogba just in front of them. And for me, Matic returning has to be one of the most crucial things to getting this team balanced this year. Balance is everything. Louis van Gaal was his favourite word. And in this occasion, I think he's absolutely correct. We need balance in this midfield, and Matic is the player who brings it. Both Fred and Pogba, very aggressive, attacking-minded midfielders. The same with Andreas Pereira. Might have been converted into a defensive midfielder, but he's not a defensive midfielder. He's learning that role. And I think playing Matic there in a midfield two alongside Fred, kind of old school. Last year, when you saw Pogba and Matic playing there at the start of the season, we were fantastic. But playing Pogba just in front of Fred allows Pogba to create more up front, and less responsibility on crafting and creating the play. That'll be down to Fred, who was also poor against Brighton. So you could argue, maybe you should bring Ander Herrera there instead of Fred. Let me know what you would do. Would you bring Herrera in against Spurs? Maybe try and close down that midfield space. Maybe we need more energy in there. And maybe Matic is the wrong player because he doesn't have that much energy. But for me, Matic is a key component of this team. He really, really is. He's that midfielder, the only midfielder I think we've got in this squad who does what he does. Protects that defence and just brings it forward and passes to a midfielder. He doesn't need to do anything flashy or anything other than win possession, break down the opposition's team and bring the ball back to Man United. And that's what we need, and that's why we need Matic back in this team. As I say, Pogba just in front of them. I don't think he'll be captain this game, not with Antonio Valencia returning. The press will definitely make a big hoo-ha of that, but it means absolutely fuck all because Valencia is the club captain. Pogba's had it for the first two games because Valencia's been out. Nothing more than that. I think Pogba's vice-captain. That's absolutely fine. But Pogba, after everything that's gone on this week with Mino Raiola, that twat of an agent, trying to stir the pot, his poor performance against Brighton, his comments after Brighton, the criticism, everything that's gone on this week, Pogba needs to put in a good performance. And he knows that. But this is a World Cup winning midfielder. This isn't the biggest game he's ever played in. By some margin, he scored in the World Cup final. Don't try and show me highlights of the Brighton game and say, Pogba's never going to be a top class central midfielder, because that's bullshit. He already is. We just need him to get the most out of himself at Man United. We need Mourinho to get the most out of Pogba at Man United. And we certainly need that against a midfield that is very, very good at Spurs. We need to close down that space. We need to make sure they don't control that midfield, because if they do, it's going to be a painful game. Now up front, I've gone for Lukaku and Lingard. Now if you hark back to, was it Chelsea a couple of years in Mourinho's first season, I think, when he played Lingard and Rashford up front, sort of went into a 5-3-2 formation. We played over the top counter-attacking football. That can work against Spurs again. They always play with a high line, and Lingard and Lukaku got pace galore. And Lingard's movement means it's going to be very hard for the Spurs defence to stop him. Now, does it mean I want to play long football towards Lukaku? No, but we've obviously got the target man in Lukaku, and he can play that role. And he can play it very well when he's on form. But playing him alongside Lingard, for me, is a good balanced pair. You could start Rashford there, you could start Martial there. Who would you start? Sanchez isn't fit, so he's not going to play in this game. But for me, that looks like quite a balanced team. I like the look of Lingard and Lukaku up front, as I said, because Spurs play that high line and we've got to utilise that. We've got to get Pogba or Fred finding the balls over the top, whether that's to Sean Valencia on the overlap or whether that is to Lingard and Lukaku up front. Spurs will play dangerous. They always play dangerous. A high press and a high line in their defence, and we've got to try and expose that sooner rather than later. Go back to last year at Old Trafford, the 1-0 win with Martial. They played with a massively high line. I was sitting in a higher than usual seat in Old Trafford. I could really see Spurs' defence was like 10 yards away from the halfway line at any one point. That's where their line sits. So if you can really expose that with the right passing and the right movement, and that is why Lingard is so crucial. Still, the kid comes into tons of criticism, but we need him in this starting 11 for me to get the best out of the shape of Man United's attack. But that is my predicted starting 11 for the game. I think there'll be changes. I think we'll definitely see Matic and Valencia return, two experienced players who Mourinho will feel he can rely on, and that's what he needs at the moment after everything that's gone on against Brighton. But who would you start against Spurs? Let me know in the comments below. As always, if you're new to the channel, drop a like on the video and subscribe to United People's TV. Take it easy.